Good morning, students of class 4. Last class, we had started the lesson Tine and the Faraway Mountain. So, I hope you all are reading how much I have taught you. What we saw in the last class was that they found out that Tine was a girl. Now, let us see what happens next in your lesson. Tine and the Faraway Mountain. Today is the 14th, okay? Now let us go to the next page and see what happens next. The officers scolded Tine for breaking the rules. So when they came to know that she was a girl, they scolded her, meaning shouted at her for breaking the rules. But they knew that Tine knew the route better than anyone else. So they allowed her to continue working. So Tine, she knew the route, meaning the direction, the path, the way. She knew the way better than anyone else. So that is why they allowed her to continue working. Her act would later help lift the ban on female porters. So what is ban, students? Ban is a law that does not allow the people to do something. So there was a ban for female porters, but as Tine was a female and she was working as a porter, her act would help to lift this ban. Okay. In the army, Tine worked on many expeditions and became a coordinator. So she worked in many expeditions and became a coordinator. What is a coordinator? Someone who plans trips to the mountains. She became the planner, okay? Someone who takes the leadership quality, okay? And plans trips to the mountains. So she became the coordinator. It was on one of her expeditions as a coordinator that she met Dr. Romeo Mithai. At that time, Dr. Mithai was working to promote adventure sports in Arunachal Pradesh. So she met this Dr. Mithai during her expeditions as a coordinator. And he was working to promote what? Adventure sports where? In Arunachal Pradesh. And he immediately identified Tine's talent. He immediately saw that Tine was very talented. Now, what is adventure sports, students? Adventure sports is exciting sports like mountaineering, water rafting, you know, all these things. And there is danger involved in these sports. Okay? There is high risk of danger and risk involved. You are naturally gifted climber, he told her. So, this doctor told her that she is a naturally gifted climber. Naturally gifted is when something you do very well, when someone does something very well without any training, they do it very nicely. So she was naturally gifted. He told her that she was a naturally gifted climber. You have the strength and determination. Now all you need is technique. He told her that she has the strength. She has the determination. What is determination? A strong desire to do something. She has the strength. She has the determination. Now all she needs is technique. Dr. Mithai became Tine's mentor and began training as a mountain climber. And began training her, you know, as a mountain climber. So he became her mentor, okay, mentor meaning teacher, and he began training her as a mountain climber. Okay, he began to train her. What is mentor? A person who helps and teaches and advise someone regularly. So like a teacher, he began to teach her and he began her training. The distant mountains still called her, but Tine did not know the name of the distant mountains till she watched the race for Everest, a film about the first climb of Mount Everest. Whoosh became a row now, and climbing Mount Everest became her dream. So she saw this movie, okay, The Race for Everest. And this was a film about the first climb of Mount Everest. And this wushu sound that she used to hear became louder and louder. And now it became her dream to climb the Mount Everest. After months of preparation, finally, Tine finally reached the Everest base camp in Nepal. So she finally reached the Everest base camp in Nepal. It was bitterly cold and the air was thin. Okay. It was very cold and the air was thin. Air was thin meaning there wasn't enough air to breathe properly because of the height of the mountain. Tine trained there for a few days to get accustomed to the harsh weather. Okay, so she began to train over there for a few days to get accustomed. Accustomed meaning used to the harsh weather and then began her climb. Okay, after that, after she got accustomed, after she got used to the weather, then she began her climb. The climb was difficult. So it was no easy climb. It was difficult. Okay. So I hope this much is clear to you students. We will do this much for today. Let us go over to the word meanings that we will learn today. Some difficult word meanings are given to you. You have to write them in your English literature copy. Learn the word meanings well. Number one, ban, a law that does not allow people to do something. Number two, coordinator, someone who plans trips to the mountains. Number three, adventure sports, exciting sports like mountaineering, whitewater rafting, and so on, usually with some danger or risk involved. Naturally gifted, someone who does something very well on his own without training. Determination, a strong desire to do something. Mentor, someone who helps, teaches, and advises someone regularly. Air was thin. There wasn't enough air to breathe properly because of the height of the mountain. Accustomed to, used to. So thank you students. I hope this much is clear to all of you. We will continue the chapter in the next class. Please read whatever I have taught you today and write and learn the word meanings well. Write the word meanings in your literature copy and learn it well and download the PPT from the link below this video and read and learn whatever I have taught you today. Thank you students and God bless you.